Hi, thank you for joining me. I'm glad you're here. I'm just in the process of using some Starbond glue to fix up my shaky hands. What I did here is when I made these joins at the end, they didn't work out very well, and consequently had one perfect and three of them were not so perfect. So I've actually done something I have never done before, and I have drilled holes at the corners, and I am in the process putting some shell in there, and I'm just cleaning that up. And I use the Starbond glue to put the shell in because it'll flood all around it and hold it very securely in place. And you'll be able to see that as soon as I get this all sanded up. However, I want to back up for a bit because I started working on the sound port. Now, we did that survey, and some of you wanted a circle, some of you wanted no sound port at all, and yet others decided they wanted the geometric. So what I did, as you can see here, take a look at this here. As you'll see right in here, I put tape over the top of the guitar, and that's just simply painter tape. And then all I did was draw some pattern similar to what I had on the previous maple guitar that you saw. So I liked the look of that, and I thought, well, okay. I tried several different things. I tried circles, I tried ovals, I tried a cross, I tried a flower. None of that worked, and we just ended up with this piece here. Now what happens, as you'll see here, I use two homemade saws that I made. These are blades from a coping saw that I simply broke off, and I took two pieces of wood, drilled a hole in the end of it, made some epoxy, put the epoxy into the hole, and then just stuck the blade in, let it dry, and now I've got two saw blades to work on the particular holes. Now you'll see in the next slide here is where I have started drilling through the holes in there to give me somewhere to start with the saw to draw the shapes or cut out the shapes. And that all went fairly well until I did one circle. And when I did that one circle, and I'll show you that because you only get to see a little bit of it, I actually ended up drilling into my finger. Now, for want of an explanation, I have an eraser here, as you can see, it bends. And I had this up underneath the guitar holding it. I had the drill in my hand coming down like this. And I've got this in here because I'm going to drill into the, once I go through the wood, I want to drill into the eraser because I don't want to blow out the wood on the other side inside the guitar. I want that nice and clean. So I get this in position here and I start down with the drill, and then this starts. My hand shakes, and it's going all over the place. And as it does, I push through with the drill, and the drill goes into my finger, as you'll see in this slide here. And you can see that immediately I took it out because I know I've just run the drill through the wood. So there's wood on the end of the drill bit, which I just drilled into my finger. So I've got wood inside my finger. I take it out and put it in my mouth, and I try to get the wood out of there. Well, it was bleeding pretty well for quite a while, and let me tell you, it very tender for more than a week and a half. This thing has really been hurting. Now, it is almost healed over, as you can see in this picture here, that I have actually been applying a bandage. I've left the bandage off so it will dry. So my grandson, Leo Santarelli, and I know a lot of you follow him on his channel, he said, well, Pop, why don't you do a video on safety in the shop? And I said, that's a great idea, but it's maybe a little bit late. So I love the humor, or actually, I think he was sincere. I don't think he was trying to be funny on this, but that nevertheless, that's just the way it came across. So we've done that. We've got it all put in place. Now, this is what it looks like now that I finished this. And you can take a look at the sound port here. Take a look. Isn't this neat? I really like this one. The circles, you'll notice, are going from a small to a medium to a large. I was going to go to a fourth, but I decided, no, I like the spacing. I like, you can see that they're getting bigger. Let's just leave it as it is. It looks nice and tidy, and it's all good. So that ends up doing the sound port. That's all finished. Yes, I did drill into my finger, and it did hurt, but it's now healed. It was suggested to me that I go to the hospital and have them put a stitch in there, but honestly, it was only about an eighth of an inch or maybe 3/16 of an inch hole, but it's perfectly round, and it got deep into the flesh, missed the bone, and we're all okay. So that's it. That is where we're at, and I'm just delighted you're here. I've got to get back to here, and I do have my Starbond thin glue here. You know, you can't build your guitar without this glue. These people are terrific. They're fast on their delivery. They give you a good product, and they give you this beautiful little wee piece of plastic that fits over the tip that lets you just put the tiniest drop on anything that you're working on. So you just tilt it up here, and you can see it coming down. Perfect. So that's it. It's all good. Now what I do is I take sandpaper and I will sand that, and that will smooth out the areas in and around, and it will fill any gaps. And then I will scrape it down so you can see the shell. It'll all come down and it'll be just perfect. It's a different look. It's a workaround. And by the way, speaking of workarounds, I've pretty well finished the book. I actually wrote a couple of extra chapters just because I could. And I wrote a chapter about an individual I had some time with a couple of weeks ago by the name of Steve. And I think you'll like what you see in that book about him. I was really impressed with that man because he is very talented, very smart, and he doesn't complain, he doesn't whine, he deals with MS. And, you know, for somebody in that situation and in a wheelchair, it could be a lot worse. And I was just blown away by his attitude. So take a look at that article. There's one up on the channel under community. And if you look at the last, I think it's the last one I put up there. Take a look and read that. I think you'll be impressed with this young man. Anyway, that's it. I'll see you in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, check out Leo Santorelli, check out Michael Builds, and it's all good, folks. We'll see you again in the next one. Bye for now.